Hello everyone, my name is Shashank and this is the free digital marketing course powered by iamshashank.com. In the lesson 7, we learned about how to set up Google Webmaster Tools with your website so that you can check if your website is indexing in Google searches, what are the crawling errors and different other metrics as well, which keywords are ranking high. Everything is actually possible with Google Webmaster Tools in terms of your website crawling rate and Google updates mainly. So it was, I believe, quite interesting and helpful for you. So now in this next chapter, lesson 8, we are going to learn about how to set up Google Analytics tool. See, Google Analytics tool is the best tool out in the market, which is totally free, and literally, trust me, this is the best tool out in the market, even from the paid tools as well. So what we are going to learn is that how to set up Google Analytics tool with your existing website, because we already set up Webmaster Tools, right? Okay, so here in this chapter, going ahead further, you can see here, in terms of going ahead and registering with Analytics tool, what you need to do is you need to check with analytics.google.com. This is a link you can follow, and you can see here I already have a website set up in this particular Analytics tool, so you don't have to wait here. Just click on this particular icon here, next to it, Google Analytics logo. Once you will click here, you can see different metrics of the website. Alright, so once you will click on analytics.google.com and you will just visit that particular link, it will be mentioned here as add new property, but I already set up with a single website already here in this account, so you don't need to go there. And if you already have any other website set up, then you can simply go to admin here in this icon, admin, and there would be an account. Thereafter, there would be a property on this particular account, so you just need to click this and create new property. Here I'm setting up with this particular link because I already have a website set up. Once you will browse through analytics.google.com, you will simply check and you will get to add website with a Google Webmaster tool. The particular link would be just on the front of the page, so you can go ahead with this. Alright, so I'm just adding up new property here. You can add your website or a mobile application. If you are a mobile application developer, you can also add your mobile app here to check the analytics, the data, what your website is producing, what website visitors are doing, what are they doing on the different pages on your website. Everything is pretty much available on this particular free tool. So let's go ahead further. I will be adding my Crazy Mite test website, I told you, right? So just Crazy Mite, you need to mention your URL, so HTTP or HTTPS. If you already have a SSL certificate, you just need to select HTTP or HTTPS. In case of a new website without SSL certificate, you need to select HTTP. Your website will be here. In my case, it's crazymite.com. You need to select an industry, whatever industry which is best suitable for your type of business, you need to select here, and Google will fetch data based on that. So I'm just selecting any such category, maybe shopping. Okay, if I have a shopping website or an affiliate website, I can choose shopping as well. What is my reporting time zones? In my case, it's India. In your case, it could be anything, so choose accordingly. Your time will automatically be displayed here. Okay, so this account has one property already. I'm going to add one more, and the maximum I have is 50 that is allowed with a single account, so it's pretty good. Okay, I'll click on get tracking ID, and here is the tracking code I got. You can see here my tracking ID is UA42723094-3. You can see this, right? Yeah, so you can edit accordingly, whatever you like. It's just a test account, so nothing. Going ahead with this, and what you need to do, This is a universal analytics tracking code for this property. To get all the benefits of your universal analytics for this property, copy and paste this code into every web page you want to track. So simply go ahead, copy this code, and what you need to do, you need to go to your website dashboard, and if you're using WordPress, you can go to your header.php file, and then you can paste this script there, right? So once you will paste this script on the header.php file, it will automatically start to track some data. It might be possible that you would not see any such data within next 2 or 3 days, because it will take some time in order to fetch data from your website, and it may also possible that your website do not have any visitors or page views as of now. So start promoting your website, start doing blogging. That is the first mandatory step. I will tell you, in 99% of cases people do blogging, so it would be great to get more visitors to your website, and definitely more visitors. If landing page is good, more sales, so it would be great for you. Alright, so you can see here, you just need to click and update, and it will be updated on your account. Alright, so I'm just showing you a couple of information here on this particular test site. You can see, right, there is no data as of now in the Crazy Mind, because I have not updated my account, I did not update my information. So what I am going to do, I am just going to show you basic data of previous time for the I'm Shashank website. Yep, I'm not doing anything actually. I'm not writing much post from the last few days because of other client works. So you can see here, I have one user right now on my website. It is a real-time data. Actually, it's a new dashboard for analytics, so many thing you will see here is pretty much new, which the recent website owners know about only. Alright, so once you will just go to analytics.google.com, and if you already added your website, this data would be available to you. It may change, however it will not be sometime. So the main thing what you need to check is the real-time data and the audience data. What you will see here is actually Google Analytics home data. Number of users who visited your website in the last 30 days, you can see here. Sessions are basically the period. Actually, a session is divided into 30 minutes period. If I'm visiting a website within 30 minutes, it will be marked as one session. However, if I will visit a website after 30 minutes, it will be marked as two sessions. One more thing, that Google actually analyzes data for the 24 hours period. So if I'm visiting a website after 30 minutes again and again, it will be marked as one session. However, after 24 hours, it will be refreshed. However, you will also see the sessions data in this analytics account, that particularly how many sessions a visitor did or visitor viewed on your website. If he's available for 30 minutes, or he just clicked on your website, checked different pages, and then after 30 minutes he again came back to your website and seen some different pages on your website, so it will be marked as two session after 30 minutes. Okay, bounce rate. See, bounce rate is 59.87%, which is good. The least bounce rate, the best your website is performing. Why? Because bounce rate is something like people just came into your website, they seen a single page, and then they definitely gone off from your website. They are not watching your website, and then if someone is just watching one page, it will be counted as a bounce rate, bounce session basically. So this rate is totally depends on how many visitors are actually visiting your website and not looking to the different second page. They are just watching one page and they are just clicking back off, so that they won't be seeing your next pages on the website. So you should be engaging with your customers so that they can watch different pages. You should align your pages accordingly so that people should visit your website and they should stay as long as they should read engaging content that they want to read. right? So it's pretty much helpful. Session duration, you could see here 1 minute 38 second is the average session a visitor is giving to my website. So 1 minute 38 second is something less as of now, however earlier it was 2 minutes around. So you could see here much data is available. You could check one by one, you could see which pages are getting more page views, everything data is available. You see different pages I have which have page views, Google AdSense approval, 233 page views, and this is something which is countable. As I do not have any particular paid links as of now on these pages, so it is pretty much clean, no value for money, but for you, you can definitely gain much knowledge on these pages. You can visit anytime. Real time is the data which is just going on real time, the name suggests it all, right? So currently one user I have on my website, you could see, because my website is open with within myself as well, so it means that I am watching my data. Okay, so it's a real time data as of now. One more thing, acquisition, you could go with, if you will click on overview, you will see the data here on which channels your traffic is coming from, right? From which channels, you could see here for the social, that is like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, here is 46% of visitors, 581 sessions has been happening, right? Direct session, direct means something like people directly type your website, like www.iamshashank.com, and they directly visited your website, so it is something like direct data. Email, I already have an email list that you are also receiving this particular video with, so this is the email list data. You could see this is the referral, 75 sessions, this is your organic searches, right? So things are going ahead for scattered data, and scattered traffic could be coming from different other sources, like some content websites, some different other links, may not be social, and if it is social it will be available here, you could see, right? And the data is for the last 7 days. See here, user retention by week, right? Active users, so everything is pretty much available on this particular account, and you can make quality decisions based on this particular data. I believe that you will be watching this video, and if you like this, I would request you to go ahead and share that video within your social account, so that other people could also get benefited with that data. Alright, okay, so good day, take care, and the next lesson would be delivered to your email shortly. Take care.